Hi, this is JP from Now the Lights Over Arkham. I decided to make a quick video while I was sleeving my Ant-Man hero pack. As we know, Ant-Man comes with this extra large hero card. So this is how I dealt with that dilemma, how to sleeve that card. So let's get started. So the rest of the Ant-Man hero pack comes in the standard size card, so they are sleeved and ready to go. The problem came when I started to sleeve the Ant-Man extra large three-sided hero card. So we have the giant Ant-Man version, which is the double size card. Then there is, of course, the alter ego side and the tiny side of Ant-Man. So usually what you would do is to have the card like this as alter ego, and as you can see it wobbles a bit. FFG told in their live stream when they were introducing the Ant-Man and Wasp hero packs that this would flat out eventually, but I'm not holding my breath for that. And also I like to sleeve my cards, so as you see the card keeps popping up, and also the, as you see, the hero, the large hero is also a bit wobbly. So I decided I won't keep tucking the card like this. So I ended up doing is I bought some big sleeves. So I found this Sleeve Kings. There might be other manufacturers, but this was what was available in my local store where I got Ant-Man. So the size you are looking for is size 88 times 125 millimeters in inches. Let's see if it reads here. Well, there is no inch size, but I think by looking with the millimeters, you will find the right size sleeve. So the sleeve is a big sleeve, as you can see. And you just normally sleeve the Ant-Man card. Okay, so the giant version is covered. It's looking good and it's all sleeved up and ready to go. The problem which arrives is when you are using the smaller sizes. So you can't, because the sleeve would crease, so you can't hold the card, so to speak. So I decided to get one opaque standard size sleeve. Then I took an exacto knife. I just put this on so I don't cut myself, and I cut along one of the edges, so to bust open the sleeve. Then I just put this on, for example, if I'm on Scott Lang, I have this sleeve like so. Now only the Scott Lang alter ego version is showing. If I want to change into tiny size, I'll just flip this over here. And now I'm Ant-Man tiny size. Then if I want to change to giant size, I just flip this card over. And it's okay like this. It's the extra sleeve is on the card. It's not the in any way bothering the play. Of course, I could just remove this while I'm using the giant side, but I found that maybe it's just better to keep it on like so. And that's how you basically resolve the dilemma of having the three sides and only having the one of the smaller size sides showing one at a time. There are other ways to do this. You could just exacto knife and cut the cards in half to have these as a separate two small cards. Then I just can't do it myself because I like so much of the big size look of this card. So I wouldn't like to have this in two parts. The other way to resolve this is that there is a US manufacturer for, I think the first time they made this side loading card protector on which there is a sliding mechanic on one side. So there is a slider that basically does this. So you can slide the card. You could do this with an opaque sleeve on top of this, but I just like that this holds better like so. But you could, if you're a US or live in the States or Canada, you could order from them. I checked their Etsy page and the postage to Europe is just too high, so I decided to make a version that is cheap for me, because I think 100 of these sleeves cost like 3 euros, so this is much way cheaper to do. And as you can see, the cut card doesn't fall off easily. Of course, if I really shake, well, it's not coming off. That's actually quite good. So I think that this is a elegant way and cheap way to resolve this problem, and you don't have to cut the card in half. So I think that's enough of this video. I want to keep this short because I'm just about to start my first gameplay of Ant-Man, so I don't want to keep myself waiting for that long. So as always, thanks for watching, and until next time.